So friends, now we know that we have fundamental charges. They may be positive or negative. Negative charge is electron, positive charge is proton. Around every charge, we have an electric field that by definition is at a point for a charge. Electric field is defined as, let's say this is your charge in question, and at this point we need to determine electric field at point P. So by definition, it is the electric field at point P due to charge Q is the force that will be experienced by a unit positive charge at this point. The direction of that force will be given by the types of charges. If this is positive and this is also a positive unit positive charge, so the direction of the force will be repulsive, that is away from this source charge, and the quantity of that force is given by the Coulomb's law, that is Q, and if this is the distance R, so this is R square. So this is the electric field around a charge. Now when we have more charges than one, or we say when we have a system of charges, then in such case we will calculate all the forces and then we will calculate the resultant force at point P, and that will be the electric field at a particular point. Friends, these electric field lines, electric charge, all these are basic concepts. They are necessary to understand and build up the concept of electric potential. But practically, in all situations of electric circuits, electric devices, electric components, we are not going to calculate electric field or electric static force. So these are basically necessary. These are the elementary concepts, and these are necessary to understand the electrical potential. But electric potential is directly applied, and it is very central to the concept of current electricity. And unless we have a clear understanding about the electric potential, we are not going to understand the circuitry of electric circuits, the basic electric components and devices, and how do they operate. So we will dive more into the information pool about the electric field and how do we interpret different aspects of electric potential. A quick recap for electric potential is, as we know, again, if we have a source charge and at a point P we want to calculate the electric potential, so by definition it is a work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to this place, and that is in the volts we say it is the electric potential of a particular point P due to charge Q. Now when we determine or assume the electric potential at this point, we assume that this remains stationary, number one, and it does not get affected by the electrostatic force that will be exerted by this unit positive charge to this source charge. So based upon this concept, if we further this concept, now we can have two situations. In situation one, that is on this side, we are bringing a negative charge, a unit negative charge from infinity towards this source charge, and in other situation we are bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to this source charge. Now what is the natural tendency? Natural tendency is this will automatically come towards this direction because the force is attractive. This is negative and this is positive. Now for this positive charge, it is going to be repulsive. The force will be in this direction, so naturally it will not come from this place to this place. So in this case, an external agency has to do some work to bring it from infinity to this point, or from infinity to this point, or from infinity to this point. Now where will this work go? If some external agency work is done and that work is apparently or indirectly not distributed in some other work or energy, that work is stored as the potential energy in this charge. Same way, if you see this case, now in this case spontaneously this will come from this place to either this point or this point. From infinity it will automatically will come from this point infinity to this point, or from infinity to this point, or from infinity to this point. So whenever we have a spontaneous movement of a charge, we say that its potential energy is decreasing, because when it is moving, naturally there will be some energy spent. And from where will this energy come? If some external agency is not giving the energy, that energy will automatically come from this charge itself. So it will lose its potential energy. So we can say, if towards attraction a charge is approaching, we will have decrease in its energy. And if against repulsion, if a charge is moving under influence of some external force, the potential energy of the charge will increase. Now at the infinity, by definition, we say that the energy, potential energy of this charge is zero. And at infinity, here also it is zero. So if I say here it is zero, and from here to here a work is done, so definitely it will increase the energy, and the energy will be in some positive value. But in this case, you know that it is again zero, but it is decreasing now. Now the energy is decreasing, so it has to be some negative value. So in other words, we can say, if a charge spontaneously moves from one point to another point under influence of electrostatic attractive force, its potential energy decreases. And if a charge is brought from one point to another point against the electrostatic repulsive force, its potential energy will be positive, and it will be increasing from its initial position to final position. Having done that, now let us interpret different cases and let us understand what this concept means to us and how are we going to apply it in our current electricity. First of all, you must remember that when we are having this explanation of potential energy, electrical potential in volts, maybe positive or negative, all these things are referred to as in a context. Now here the context is, this is a large charge, and in this context we have electric field and we have electrostatic force. For this it is attracting, for this it is repulsive, right? So this whole thing belongs to this frame of reference. Now when I say that at infinity the potential energy is zero, I mean to say with respect to this. This may be having some potential energy if it is having some other charge or some earth potential or some other source of electrostatic force. So we have to contain and we have to limit ourselves into our context and our frame of reference. So when I say that this energy is zero, it is a convention that we assume that with respect to this central source charge, the energy is zero at infinity. And what does it mean? It means that at infinity there is no influence of this charge on this charge and this charge, which means it is not exerting any electrostatic attraction force at this charge or any electrostatic repulsive force at this charge. So this is the conceptual meaning about what do you mean by potential energy is zero at infinity. Now, one thing which is very easy to memorize is, I always tell to my students that how do you know that whether the potential energy is decreasing or increasing, whether it is positive or it is negative? It is very simple. You just see what is happening. If a charge is moving on its own, spontaneously it is moving from one point to another point, we will simply say that it is decreasing. The potential energy, because the energy has to come from the charge only, because we are not doing any external work, this is done by the charge itself, so the energy will decrease. And when we say that the charge is spontaneously not moving towards a direction, we have to force it, we have to put some external agency, we have to put some external pump to make it shifting from one point to another point. Now where will our work go? Automatically it will be stored into the potential energy of this charge. And this means that if against a force, if a charge is moving, we are increasing its potential energy. This can be either ways. If this charge from here it is moved here, potential energy will increase because it is moving away from that direction. If this charge is moved from here to here, potential energy will increase because now it is against. Force is here, you are moving this direction. Here the force is here, you are moving this direction. So in both the cases you can see the potential energy will decrease if the movement or if the charge is moving in the same direction as the force between them. And if the charge is moving in the direction opposite, it is going to be the increase of the potential energy. Now let us understand the natural tendency of movement for a charge in a particular situation. We again take this example. What is the natural tendency of this charge? The natural tendency of this charge would be to move in this direction because the force is attractive. And in this situation, the natural tendency of the charge would be to move in this direction because the force is repulsive. And you see, when this charge is moving from this place, potential energy is decreasing. And you see this charge, when it is moving from this point, potential energy is again decreasing. We do more work when we move it from here to here, and we do less work when we move it from here to here, which means this is at higher potential, this is at lower potential. So the other interpretation or the other statement or the other way of stating it would be that the charge will always try to lose its potential energy spontaneously. Spontaneous movement of a charge would always be in the direction in which its resultant potential energy is going to decrease. And this is very analogous to a gravitational potential situation also. You know, you have a ball here, and let's say you have stepladder. So if this ball will have a tendency to come, if we just push it to this edge, this ball will come down and it will again come down like this, and finally it will be at the ground. So the natural tendency of a ball is always to come down. We have to do work to put it back to the upper stair steps. So natural tendency of movement of a mass is also same as it is in the case of electric charges. But there is a fundamental difference between two. This situation, I have drawn it on this side with a particular reason, because the peculiarity or the difference between gravitational potential energy or gravitation and electricity is, in electricity we have two type of forces, repulsive force and attractive force. But in gravitation we only have attractive force. So you will never have a situation in which you will find that two masses are repelling each other. So because of this reason, sometimes there is a confusion. So we always have zero maximum potential energy. We will never have potential energy of a mass, a gravitational potential energy of a mass in positive value, because at infinity it will be at zero, and along the line of attraction the energy will decrease, which means it will be negative and negative and negative. So it will never come to a value which is positive. Positive would come if we push against some force that is inherently seen in this case, but here the force is always attractive. So if along, you know, it is very simple to understand, if we have attraction, so there is no need to push, they automatically are moving in the towards each other. So there is no point that some external agency is required to meet two masses. So the masses will always have decrease of potential energy. They will, and the spontaneous movement will always be in the direction from zero to negative value of gravitation potential energy. Though there are some school of thoughts that say that zero potential energy is a notion only. We can take zero potential energy anywhere, and depending upon the zero point, we decide whether positive is this or negative is this. So that is something which remains with the convention also. Sometimes we take the gravitational potential energy zero at the ground. So when it is zero at ground, we say it is more here. So in that case, you have a positive value of gravitational potential energy. You have a value of, let's say, 40 here, 30 here, 10 here, and 0 here. So what you can see, it is decreasing. So if you see at infinity is it is 0, you say it is negative. So that is a convention we always take. So potential energy being 0 is dependent upon the convention, what arbitration you have taken. But this is a fact that if spontaneously something is moving towards the attractive force, the potential energy from initial point to potential energy at the final point will always be decreased. And if something is moving against the repulsive force and some external work is done on that body, the potential energy at the initial point will be lesser and the potential energy at the final point will be higher. So this was about the natural tendency of the charges. If let free, where would they move? This would move in this direction, this would move in this direction. Both would move in the direction in which their potential energy is going to decrease from their initial position. Now, previous notion was when the charges are moving, because mechanics were more established before electricity concepts came up. So when the charges are moving, and as per the Newtonian physics, it was always like to move some body or to move some mass, we need force. So sometimes this potential or this electric potential is also referred to as electromotive force, which means the force which pushes or which moves this charge from one point to another point. But now this is clear that it is not electromotive force, it is basically electric potential or electrical potential energy. In some way you can say, well, how do you gain electric potential? Some work has to be done. So in this case, prior to this event, some work was done by some external agency. So that force was there, but prior to this movement, that force is not directly applied for this movement. We applied some force on this charge and it got shifted from this point to this point. So that force was applied, but that was not electromotive force. That was just some force, it can be of any type. It can be mechanical, it can be thermal, whatever. So a charge was moved from one place to another place, a force was required. But now that force is converted into the potential energy at this point. And now if let free, this charge will move back from this place automatically to lose back its potential energy gained in the previous event. So electromotive force is a wrong notion. These days in modern physics, we say it is either electrical potential or electrical potential energy. However, prior to this gaining of potential energy, there must be some force that was applied against the electrostatic forces to gain this potential energy. Otherwise, you know that at the both ends it is zero. So if this charge is brought from here to here, some potential energy is gained, so it will come back here because the attraction is here. This charge is pushed from this place to this point, and if let free, this will come back here because again some work is done from this place to this place, because this is against the force and this is also against the force. Force is attractive, you are moving from here to here. So these small things are very important to understand. Now, based upon our understanding of electric potential, now we know that since electric potential is due to this source charge, number one, at a particular point, number two, and due to this charge on which this electric potential is acquired. So there are two, three things that need to be considered before assigning a particular point and electric potential. So based upon this, now we can map electric potential around a charge, assuming that if a unit positive charge is brought at this point or this point or this point or anywhere between infinity to the sphere, we will have different value of electric potential, because you know that at different point we will have different value of electric field, and against or towards that electric field the work is done. So the work done will be different for different points. There may be some points which will have same work done, and those points are known as equipotential points. So we do mapping of electric potential. Let's say we have points on which we are doing this we are finding electric potential here, then here, then here, then here, then here. So randomly I am drawing some points on which. So this is how we do mapping of electric potential around this source charge, right? And now we have, let's say, some value V1 here, V2 here, V3 here, V4 here, V5 here, V6 here. So these are the different values of the work done that are being stored in these cases, or that these are the electric potential values at several points due to this charge for the unit positive charge. In case we have a charge more than unit positive charge, we multiply and we get the final electric potential of a particular charge. If for a unit, if V is electric potential and we have Q, so we say QV. QV is going to be the potential of a charge which is more than unit. Now once we know all these values, if we start subtracting V1 minus V2, that means work done to bring a charge at V1, and then work done to bring a charge at V2, and what is the difference between these two works done? So if this is V1 minus V2, same way we can have V1 minus V3, we may have V2 minus V3, so we can have several values. So now these are the potential differences between two points specified by these potentials. So if I say V1 minus V2, this is going to be the potential difference between these two points, which means the work done difference between these two points. If I bring a unit positive charge here, and if I bring a unit positive charge here, we will have two different works. And if we subtract them, we get the potential difference between these two points. This is commonly referred to as voltage in our electric circuits. This is a very common term. We'll be using it quite oftenly in our further concepts and discussions. So this potential difference is known as voltage. Now we may have situations in which we will have V1 minus V2 zero. We may have situations in which we will have V1 minus V2 some positive value. We may have situations in which we can have these values negative also. And this is same for every. Here also we can have, or we can write like this, we can have positive or negative values. Let's see again. At this point, we have a potential. Let's say again, this is V1. And at this point, we have V2. We know that this is higher. This is higher. And this is lesser. So V1 minus V2 will be a negative value, because V1 is smaller and V2 is higher. Why is it higher? Because this distance is more. So we are doing more work against the force when we are bringing it from here to here. And why is it smaller in this case? Because this distance is lesser. So we will be doing less work because the force is same and the work is F dot S. So the displacement here is lesser, displacement here is more. So V2 is going to be more and V1 is going to be less. So we will have a situation in which this value will be negative. Now if we change it, if we see it like this, suppose this is V1 and this is V2. So now in this case, we will have V1 minus V2 positive, because you know that the V1 now is more and V2 now is less. So it depends from point to point. They may have a positive value, they may have a negative value, or they may have a zero value. Now how do we have zero value? Because if I draw a circle like this, for all these points, I'm drawing points with some separate colors. So for all these blue points, you can see the distance is same. So if same charge from infinity is brought to this point or this point or this point, nothing is changing. The distance is same. The distance is same. Source charge is same. And the same charge is brought. So if the same charge is brought under influence of the same source charge at the same distance, we are going to have all these values same. And when we subtract this value from this value, we are going to have this zero. So there is a possibility that we will have, like, generally we say that there is a spherical symmetry for potential around a point charge, which means for the whole sphere of the same radius on all the points, we will, like, from here also, or at here also, all these points which are equidistant from this place will have same potential. So all such points are known as equipotential points. And when we try to calculate the potential difference of two equipotential points, it is going to be zero because the potential difference is same. So we may have different conditions in which the potential difference can have a positive value, or it can have a negative value, or it will have a zero value. Now, depending upon these two, three situations, it is decided that where the charge would move if let free. Where the charge would move if let free. Now, you know, at this point, let's say at V1, potential is high, and at V2, potential is lower. And what is the natural tendency? The natural tendency is of the charges to move in the direction in which, or to move towards the point in which it loses its potential energy. So now this is clear. If I say this is higher, this is lower, so the charge would move from V1 to V2. In other words, we can say if let free, spontaneously the charges, electrical charges, would try to move in the direction in which they lose their electric potential energy spontaneously. Now we know that if we do not have two points equipotential, there will be a potential difference between those two points. And if let free, the charge will spontaneously move from higher potential to lower potential. This movement, this spontaneous movement of charge under influence of electrical potential energy, in which it moves from higher potential to lower potential, is referred to as electric current. I repeat, this spontaneous movement of charge from one point to another point under influence of potential difference, wherein it loses its potential energy from its initial position to final position, is referred to as electric current. Please understand this thing in this way, that if a charge is moving, but it is not moving under influence of potential difference, we are not going to consider this as electric current. I give you an example. Suppose there is a block which is positively charged. Now, if I hit this block, this will move from this place to this place until its kinetic energy comes to rest. But this movement is not the movement which is spontaneous, number one. And this is not the movement which is influenced by some potential difference. So this movement is just movement, it is a mechanical movement. It is, the charge is moving here from one place to another place. But this movement will not be considered, and actually it is not electric current.